All right, what's going on, everybody? Welcome to another video. This time we're talking 5 questionably useful Git tips and riding my EUC, because this video is just supposed to be a little bit fun. So we're gonna start off in Brooklyn, ride into Manhattan, stop at a couple cool destinations along the way, and end with number 5, which is not only my favorite tip, but also my favorite little hidden location. We're starting in Brooklyn, so I'll see you there. Oh, shit. Woo. All right, first tip. Did you know that you can create empty commits? Yeah, well, the allow empty flag exists pretty much exactly for this purpose. So if you want, go ahead and stage no changes, and then just run the git commit command with the --  allow empty flag, and there you go, a commit with absolutely nothing in it. Bonus points if you go ahead and change that commit message to something super enticing like, ooh, cool feature, check it out. And then while you're at it, why not update the commit's author to Jorf Borzos, and then tuck that commit away so that your coworkers wonder why Jeff Bezos's alter ego is part of your on-call rotation. Next tip. Welcome to the Williamsburg Bridge. Connects Williamsburg, Brooklyn to Chinatown and the Lower East Side. All right. So to get over my fear of crippling embarrassment from doing this in public, oh, there's a train. And why do these trains never run when I need to get home? Tip number 2, did you know that not only can you create empty commits, but you can also create orphan commits as well? Well, we all know that commits have a parent, which would be the commit that directly precedes it. But in the case of merge commits, you have 2 parents. But you could also create an orphan branch, which is completely separate, not connected at all to any other branch. And your commits are now separate from the family, I guess. Just use the --  orphan flag when you check out the branch, and there you go. And as far as I could tell from reading an article about halfway before I got bored and stopped, there's probably use case for this, but like I said, I was too impatient to finish the article, so it's probably pointless. Next tip. If you ever come to New York, I'm underneath the, I guess, the West Side Highway. And they've been doing a lot of work down here, reclaiming some of this waterfront back into businesses and parks and things like that. So you gotta love the city taking back space that was formerly for cars. Big plus on that, but they still got a little ways to go, especially on these bike lanes. Oh no, it was a bad idea. I just got new shoes. Welcome to the financial district and the location of our 3rd tip. But before we can get there, I want to show you this, one of the oldest subway stations in New York, Bowling Green. All right, welcome to the southern tip of Manhattan. To my left, you got the iconic Statue of Liberty, and what a perfect place for tip number 3. Did you know that you can get some pretty interesting statistics using your Git repository? Well, let me tell you about it. You can check how many lines of code an author committed, and guess what? The command is super duper simple. All you gotta do is pop open your terminal and enter git log --  author equals jack lot --  pretty equals t format colon --  numstat type character --  okay, yeah, and see, it's really that simple. Dang it, well, it's supposed to show how many lines I removed. You know, it was just for the joke anyway to type it out, so we're just gonna copy and paste it. Boom! See, I committed 66 lines to this project. And if you don't want to go through all that trouble, there is an open source utility for stats called Git Quick Stats that makes this way easier. But this is all pointless anyway, because we all know that the most representative performance metric for software engineers is whether or not they come to the office. All right, Jassy?
Culture is so strong.
Well said. See, I don't work in Amazon, so I can make these kind of jokes. As we head over to the location of tip number 4, and also speaking of Amazon, I didn't leave Amazon after 7 years of professional software development to start a business, but I find myself solidly on that path at the moment. And later on this year, I'm gonna be launching learngit.io, which is gonna be a fully fledged online tool for Git learning. It's gonna feature the visualization style that you're seeing in this video, plus a whole lot more cool features specific to learning Git, especially all those little tricky situations that are hard to parse with just written documentation. I have a newsletter, you can access it, waitlist.learngit.io, that features sneak peeks of what the service is gonna look like. And also I talk about some of the trials and tribulations of leaving a full-time job to start a business. I think that stuff's kind of interesting, and if you do too, really help me out to sign up for that waitlist and let me know what you think. Anyways, let's get on to tip number 4. All right, right, here we are at tip number 4, and what a spot do we have here. Right now I'm on the Little Island, that's its name. It's a park built on these tulip-like structures in the Hudson River. Pretty cool. It was built, I think, finished at least last year, but it's a little bit crowded during the day, but I really like coming here at twilight. It is awesome. And for this tip, we're gonna do something a little bit different, a legitimately useful tip before we get to our 5th questionably useful tip. So we're gonna talk about git log. This is probably one of the most used git commands that you'll find in your day-to-day work. And did you know that you can extend it to be even better?
Try passing the --/ one line flag the next time you're using log. You'll now get one commit per line and have a much easier time scanning your commit history. Word's not your thing? How about a visualization? Try passing the graph and decorate flags to get a basic visualization of your history. Now, this doesn't look nearly as good as some dedicated Git GUIs, but hey, it's built in. Lastly, did you know you can customize your log output? Well, in similar fashion to how you might customize a bash or ZSH prompt, try passing your own format strings with custom attributes and colors. And with those 3 tips, Git log just got a whole lot better.
Enough useful tips. Let's get on to number 5, my favorite tip and my favorite destination. Let's go. All right, and as we're pulling into this final destination and tip number 5, I just wanna say, thanks for sticking around if you made it this far. This is definitely a new type of format. It's just having a little fun, but let me know what you think about it in the comments and maybe I can do more if people are liking it. And looks like we're here. If Little Island was Manhattan's worst kept secret, then this is definitely Manhattan's best kept secret, because I don't know if you can see off to my left, but you get an absolutely fantastic view of Manhattan, and it doesn't even look like you can go down this pier, but you can. As you can tell by the amount of people here, not a lot of people know about this. And if you Google, I'll bring it up on my phone, but it's like the pollen tunnel ventilation shaft number 3 or whatever, you can find out where I'm talking about. But I digress, because we're in need of our 5th pointless Git tip. My question to you, do you ever misspell Git commands? And that's not rhetorical, because of course you do. Well, if you do, there's this awesome utility called the fuck, which basically, excuse the language, unfucks any spelling error. Just install it, and then after you enter a command incorrectly, just type fuck, and it'll unfuck itself. Cool thing here is that it works not only on misspellings, but also misconfigurations. So for example, if you ever tried to push a branch without specifying an upstream, well, the fuck can take care of that as well. And if swearing isn't your thing, and maybe you're from Wisconsin, go ahead and alias it to whatever you want. For example, you might want to gosh darn it your misspellings. And bonus tip number 6 before I get on out of here, did you know that you can use Git in VR? Well, neither did I, and you can't really. But somebody in Germany did write a paper about it, shout out Roy Oberhauser. But yeah, I originally thought Git in VR would be pointless, but after looking at his paper, maybe it's got some potential.
And with that, I think I better get out of here before you all realize that most of these tips might actually be useful after all. See ya!